Thanks a lot. Welcome everybody. Today is the final day of class in the class Neuroeconomics at the Erasmus School of Economics. My students are going to present their final presentation on neuroscience and neuroeconomics. And I'm very curious what they have to say because this has been a challenging and interesting class. Thanks a lot. Good luck.
Well, as we all know, the animal kingdom exists of groups, so it is not uncommon to see groups in the animal kingdom. So as you can see, wolves travel in packs, and sheep in flocks, cows in herds, and fish in schools. But our question was, what about we as humans? Do we also have the tendency to be in groups? Or are we an individual? Because for quite some time now, the human has been seen as an individual. So we seem to like doing things on our own, or even think we are better at doing things on our own. People have the tendency to conform to what people in a group do. A group of consisting of a test person and six or seven actors were shown these pictures, and they had to say which of the lines, A, B, or C, were the same length as the first line. For the first two pictures, the actors would give the same correct answer, so the participant would feel at ease and knowing that the actors all aren't actors. But from the third picture on, they will all give the same wrong answer. And Ash wanted to see if the test person would confirm to these wrong answers. And the tests showed that eventually the test person would give in to the power of the group and give the same wrong answers. Now, from these experiments can be derived that we as humans are not so individual as we might think we'd be. So what this explains is that you do have bonding and trust within groups, but those groups don't apply for the whole human being, but just for a certain kind of groups. And marketing actually plays really good, sees clearly how those groups work. Marketing also plays in the fact that if you're not in the in-group, you're actually kind of a loser and you should be in the in-group and you should want to be in the in-group. So you have to buy the stuff that the in-group uses. But it also shows that it's really important to have people who don't conform to the group process and actually have a leader. And University of Leeds showed that that is actually possible, that we, as in crowds, only need 5% of the crowd to lead us somewhere. So it is actually, we are capable of following a leader. And that is why in companies, they also have CEOs and directors, so that we are not just a bunch of people who all think alike and just do what other people do because we are used to that. And the conclusions, we have seen that humans are herd animals based on the experiments of Ash, and that oxytocin is one of the things that plays part in this because it makes sure that we as human beings bond and we trust each other, but that trust and bonding is not always in a group as a whole, but mostly in groups and out groups. And we have to follow the leader. And if you don't think you are a herd animal, although I've said a lot of things about it, there's a video which I think will make you think otherwise.
Really?
Really? Really?
It's time for a phone to save us from our phones. New Windows Phone, designed to get you in and out and back to life.
There we go.